Hi, my name is Ok. Futura never had ABS, so I decided to fit one. In 2004-2005, Futura should get its facelifted version, but that never happened. The facelifted version should get optional ABS, power socket and navigation system, but instead of that, only its sibling Capo Nord got the ABS system, which works fairly well. Capo Nord's ABS system is fairly similar to the one as found on a BMW F650, GS or CS or whatever version. So I'll take these two bikes as an example and take some of their parts. ABS system. What it basically does is it senses wheel speed. So we have a wheel, we have a brake, and we've got a wheel speed sensor. So as a normal brake, we've got a brake line and master cylinder. So I can write something like that. This is our brake lever. You pull it. On ABS system, we've got a hydraulic unit in between, and we got an electronic unit that senses the speed of a wheel. Of course, to make things easier, we've got another speed sensor on another wheel, and this electronic unit controls speed of one and another wheel and compares them. So this is a basic ABS system. This is our brake. This is a brake caliper, master cylinder, brake lever, brake lines, and this is our speed sensor, hydraulic unit, electronic unit. So what this electronic unit does is it senses braking. When we start to brake, if we brake hard enough, we lock a wheel. And this electronic unit senses through a wheel speed sensor that a wheel has locked while another one is still spinning. It lowers brake fluid pressure to allow the wheel to start spinning again. And as it starts to spin again, it continues to brake again like it did before. This is usually a repeatable cycle. So what we have here is a one channel ABS, which means it can only take care of one brake. And here we got a two channel ABS system where it senses which wheel locks and can independently lower brake pressure on either of brakes. So what we have on our Futura is one brake, another brake, brake caliper, one master cylinder, another master cylinder. This is the difference between an ABS equipped bike and non-ABS bike. Now I will have to add a hydraulic and electronic unit in between here, wheel speed sensor, ABS ring on front and rear wheel, and some tiny bits of electronics like brake pressure switch for front and rear wheel, and of course power supply and such things. So what I have here is an ABS unit of a BMW F650 CS. This one didn't work. I tried to connect to it with a computer and didn't go very well. And what we see here, and so we've got two parts. This is a hydraulic part. This is electronic part. This is a computer, the brain of an ABS unit. Up here is a pump, electric pump, electric motor that takes care of braking pressure. So inside of this unit is a little bit complicated. So here's a housing. So I won't get too much into details of how this unit works. The main thing is that it works, right? These are four valves, two for each channel, and here are connections. Here's a master cylinder one, a slave cylinder one, which F means front brake. This is a master cylinder two, and R for rear brake. So I was a bit unlucky by buying these ABS units. This is my second one, and the second one that doesn't work. The first one was sent for another bike, for F800 instead of 650, which is a totally different unit. This one works via a CAN bus. Pardon, this one works via K-line, and the one of F800 works via CAN bus. So when I got the first unit, I also bought some brake lines that would fit it. So you got a whole set of them and screws and everything. But that unit is a bit different. These fret sizes are not the same. See, this is M10 and this is M12. And because I bought brake lines for the unit of F800, this unit won't fit, so I have to buy some adapters. This is M10 to M12 adapter. But these adapters also won't seal well, so I have to modify them a little in a way that they will make a perfect fit. Yeah, something like that. Well, there are other units I could use. I've chosen a BMW. One of the reasons why is because it is exactly the same unit as in Caponort. While Caponort is almost the same bike, electrically speaking, than Futura. And the other reason is that I've got a whole bunch of diagnostic equipment for BMWs, and I could literally connect to anything. I've made few calculations which exact unit to choose. The big problem with that unit is that it's probably not programmable. I could not hack in and adjust few parameters, like how many impulses per revolution of wheel do I need. So I made a few calculations. I've collected wheel sizes and calculated wheel diameters. Why is that important? Because basically every ABS unit uses the same amount of pulses per revolution, and while these diameters aren't the same for front and rear wheel, the ratio between front and rear is very important. Aprilia Futura uses very common wheel sizes, which leads us to this result. This is the ratio. This is the front diameter and rear diameter, and the ratio between them is 0.952, which means that front wheel is 59.2% as large as the rear wheel. The F650CS has quite similar ratio, 0.939, which is close enough. It should work without problem. But these units are a bit harder to get and more expensive than F650GS. But this bike has a front wheel larger than a rear wheel. So wheel size ratio for F650GS is 1.036. Well, this difference is large enough so it could cause problems. Well, but if we replace front and rear wheel and calculate it backwards, we get something completely different, 0.965. Well, these two numbers are not too far apart, which means that with in that way it could work. How? I would have to change channels, like this channel is for rear brake and this channel is for front brake. So I should just turn them around electrically and hydraulically and everything should work as it should. Which means that this list of connections will have to be changed a little bit. This will be a front wheel sensor, this will be a rear wheel sensor. This will be a front brake switch and this will be a rear brake switch. That's about as much as it gets. I will have to try to see how it works out. This is one of the two ABS sensors. One will be for a front wheel and another one for rear wheel. There are two basic types of them. This is a Hall type, Hall sensor, and another type is inductive. Here I have an electronic unit. This is hooked to the battery, some measuring equipment, and here I have two ABS sensors. But its internal power supply unit obviously shut itself. As soon as I hook up one of those sensors, their voltage simply drops to zero. So I guess I will have to wait for another ABS unit to come. This simply won't work. What we got here is a ABS ring. It's got 43 teeth and I'm going to use it with the front wheel. But here is more than enough space to fit it. All I need to do is to weld some holders, some brackets that will hold it in its place. Oh, they're not something I was expecting. 80 millimeters in diameter, which is much more than I wanted. Sensor here somewhere. So my rear brake basically shut itself. I can push as much as I want and it won't do a thing. I think it's time to upgrade things a little bit. That's it for today. I hope it will be an interesting journey. I hope I make it. If I do, I guess it will be a first ABS equipped Futura in the world. If you find it interesting, subscribe. I'll do my best to keep you posted in every little detail. Bye.